Will it rain today? Was I also hired to be a meteorologist in my sleep? Like, I don't even know how I got here, dude. Like, I was walking to a different job and they just abducted me. I guess it could rain promotions. My first day here, and yet apparently I've got a promotion lined up already. You know what? It depends on your mood. This is a Nickelback concert, after all. The audience is 100% women. So, you know, once they get on stage and start swooning, you're not gonna need a cloud in the sky to be dancing in puddles. Trust me, it smells like a friggin' lobster farm out here. What's up, guys? Welcome back to Speak to the Manager, that game that I think we all know should have been called Karen Simulator, but no one wants to bring it up with the developers, because that's a real Karen thing to do. You know, last time, we did a pretty good job working our way through all of the customer complaints at the airport, an armed robbery at the cereal and cat food emporium, an alien invasion at the murderer hardware store, you know, all so that we could afford the luxury of living in a crack den. And I'm gonna take some responsibility for this, okay? It is partially my fault. I probably shouldn't have spent my first paycheck on a pet rabbit, which may or may not be invisible, considering I've never actually seen the thing before. I have no idea where it is, but I do know that it's full of poop. And if that poop ends up being invisible too, then we're soon gonna have a lot of pellet-sized problems. I'm kind of afraid to take this thing for a walk. Like, it cost me $500. If it slipped its leash and ran away or something like that, how would I ever know? On the other hand, I really don't want to find out what happens when you reach 101% invisible poop bunny. So I guess we're gonna go for this walk. Oh, you're not invisible! What, do you live in my couch or something like that? Can you please do your business? I really don't like holding eye contact with something that's pooping $503. What? I mean, I've heard of geese laying golden eggs before, but never rabbits laying golden turds. Like, just so we're on the same page, it took me 4 days of full-time work across 3 different jobs to earn that much money. Meanwhile, I could've just bought a pound of carrots and had a fall out of Peter Contail's fuzzy anus. Like, clearly, we need to use this money to spruce up the place. Maybe some wallpaper, some paint, windows that don't have holes in them. I'm gonna wait. Tomorrow's payday, so how about we go to work first? Do you offer vegetarian food? Lady, it's telling me here on your itinerary you've got a 39-minute flight ahead of you. You're not getting any food! I mean, I would give you a complimentary bag of salty nuts, but I don't really want to get me too'd out of my job, so how about you just eat what everyone eats? And stop looking at your damn wrist, all of you! None of you are wearing a watch on your weird little fleshy crab hands. Yeah, you see this? It's called a finger. Go find some. I need to change my flight. Can you do it for free? I'm sorry, weren't you in here asking for free stuff on my last shift? And the shift before that? And the shift before that? Like, how about this? I'll make a deal with you. I'll waive the $200 fee to get your flight changed this one time, but if you come back here asking for free stuff one more time, I'm gonna label you a flight risk and tell Joe with the big fingers that you've got booger sugar up your nose. So unless you want the Jim Henson treatment, don't come back. Man, I am sick of doing stunts for Tom Cruise. I sincerely doubt you legally changed your name to Stuntman. And just so you know, you can't use a fake name in an airport, idiot. Also, you look like you ate Tom Cruise. Like, how about this? I'm gonna ease your pain by watching an ad, even though I paid to get rid of them, because apparently I've lost my chance at a promotion today by telling those last two people to shove it. I mean, they're probably not gonna need this first aid kit in the plane, right? Thank you for the tip. What should I order for my meal? I don't know where the confusion is coming from, but this is airport customer service, not your Instagram stories. I can't legally tell you to eat my meat or gargle my nuts. It's like I told the last lady. Wait, it's the same lady! She just came back! Okay, well then maybe you are interested in my nut proposition. I get off at 5, I'll show you my crack den. Do I really have to pay an oversized luggage fee? You don't have a suitcase with you. If that's some kind of code to say you've got a big dick, I'm not interested. Like, I don't understand why I can only date guys. It just doesn't make any sense. Charlie, Charles, Chuck, can I call you Chuck? I can't risk losing this promotion. And I don't want to risk you losing those track pants. So I'm sorry, it's mandatory. You're just gonna have to pay. Have a nice day. There we go. The business goes up in value, and I get promoted to airline manager. I've been dealing with Karens all day, and I wasn't even the manager? Somewhat later. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Did vegetarian Karen actually take me up on my nut offer? I should go talk to her. Oh, right. I forgot I actually have a girlfriend. It's just that this is the first time I've ever seen her. She's been about as invisible as my rabbit. So we can say hello with a drink, we can leave her alone, or we can cheer her on by watching another ad. I'm so happy I spent that $5 to get rid of ads just to watch a bunch of ads. It makes me very happy though. I got 125 smile emojis. She's got some moves too. I like her. Oh, I see. So now we're level 2 of our relationship. She makes me happy every day. And once we reach 600 happiness, then first base, I guess. Maybe a little titty, you know, under the shirt, over the bra sort of thing. If that's gonna be the case, then I really need to sort my life out. Let's go shopping. Having a bed is nice, but we clearly want to get it to the point where it can fit 2 people. So for $600, you wouldn't think IKEA would deliver via confetti cannon, but I'll go get the broom. How do you decorate a kitchen that looks like it survived a nuclear bomb test? Oh, the answer is you don't. Don't get me wrong, okay? Having drapes on the broken windows is an improvement, but I'd kind of like to fix the windows. I'm really hoping that wall will do that. Maybe we can get rid of some of this cement while we're at it and just replace it all with blood? I'm sorry, how did we go from crack den to crime scene? Crime scene without any drafts. I can't believe I have to spend another $1,000 to fix this, but like, I don't want my girlfriend to think that I'm bringing girls back here all the time and then chopping them into pieces. So clearly whatever this is will be an improvement. Okay, that's better. While we're at it, I suppose we could replace the piss-soaked floors, but I swear to God, if they give me like chalk outlines of bodies, I'm gonna lose my mind. Just give me nice, clean, hardwood floors. That's what I'm talking about. And apparently I have some kind of social event waiting for me at the restaurant. Since when do I work at a restaurant? I don't understand why my rabbit is full of poop again. It's only been a day. Do you need to poop every day? Come on now. Let's go for your walkies, I suppose. There you are. Come on now, Papa needs a new kitchen. Aw, 365. Someone's gonna get fed extra tomorrow. Do you sell a backstage pass? I'm sorry, what is happening right now? I apparently work at a restaurant and a hardware store and an airport, and I was just on my way to the cereal and cat food emporium, but apparently I made a quick stop to be a bouncer at a Nickelback concert. Lady, are you sure you want to go backstage with Nickelback? Like, I don't think it'd be all that interesting to watch them power down and be wheeled into the recharge stations. I mean, for $100, you can sit on Chad Kroeger's face for all I care. Technically, it's only $99.95, but I don't have any change. Will it rain today? Was I also hired to be a meteorologist in my sleep? Like, I don't even know how I got here, dude. Like, I was walking to a different job and they just abducted me. I guess it could rain promotions. My first day here, and yet apparently I've got a promotion lined up already. You know what? It depends on your mood. This is a Nickelback concert, after all. The audience is 100% women. So, you know, once they get on stage and start swooning, you're not gonna need a cloud in the sky to be dancing in puddles. Trust me, it smells like a friggin' lobster farm out here. When does Taylor Swift play? I think it's usually after one boyfriend, but before the next. I'm gonna pretend like I have no idea who you're talking about, because this is a Nickelback concert. Or at least, I hope it is. Otherwise, I've been making a real ass out of myself this entire time. Oh, where is the bathroom? This is the exact reason why you never eat concert curry. Okay, we ran out of toilet paper a long time ago, dude. I hope you're wearing socks, because you already had to lose the sleeves. I guess technically the tie would be after that, but... I don't have diapers, I'm sorry. It's around the corner. Just hope for the best. Fingers crossed. Can I pay after the event? Was I supposed to be making people pay before they get in this entire time? Like, I've had four people pass me and not a single person has given me money. Fortunately, it looks like the event will never end. I don't really know what that means. I'm guessing this is gonna be some kind of soft rock purgatory. Yeah! Joke's on you, lady. You're gonna rot here forever. Okay, so we made some decent money. Now, hopefully I can get home without being employment abducted again. Oh, I don't work at a restaurant. There was a social event after work waiting for me at the restaurant. So once again, I'm going on a date with... you. Haven't quite caught her name yet. But things seem to be going well. We had a really good chat. I'm gonna do something very sweet. And then I'm gonna finish off my JPEG of spaghetti. The nice thing about two-dimensional food is it leaves a whole lot of space for a big cup of whatever that was. Okay, this is good. It's making us happy. Things are going well. We're getting closer to titty. I still have no sweet clue where Peter Pooper is. He's nowhere in the apartment. I'm guessing he does live in the couch, in which case he might want to get out because the IKEA cannon is about to blast it. I want to make this a little bit more comfortable for when my lady friend comes over. Okay, look at that. I've got a TV that isn't a cardboard box. We might want to tune up the old desktop too. It's a little sad to have a computer desk and your computer is a sheet of loose leaf and a pen. So maybe for a couple $100 we can... get ourselves a nicer desk and more paper. I think the IKEA cannon may have literally scared the crap out of Peter Pooper. He's only got two modes, 0% and 100%. He's empty or full, but either way, he's actually a really good investment. He's probably better than working, so I'm thinking maybe we should get another pet. For $1,000, we can get ourselves a cat. Oh boy, I'm just now realizing there are a lot of pet possibilities. So hold on a second. What would I get for $2,000? A chihuahua, okay. And now I'm out of money and I've tripled the poop, but that should mean a whole lot more money. Can I see any of them? Nope, of course not. I want to build a moat. Can you help me? If you mean can I show up to your suburban bungalow and dig a crocodile-filled hole around your house, then no, I can't do that. But you know what? I like the way you think. We don't have enough lawn moats these days. They would come in real handy, so you're gonna need a lot of supplies. Try aisle 7, maybe. I don't really know. Ooh. Promotion? I'm really broke right now. Can I have this for free? Mrs., I'm gonna tell you what I've told everyone else. The divorce attorney shovel isn't cheap by any means, but it's way cheaper than the alternative. No freeloaders. If you want to get rid of your husband, this is the least expensive option. I'm looking for a lot of lubricant. A lot is a relative amount. Are we talking like peen in the pooper amount of lubricant? Or like smuggle a horse in your butt level of lubricant? Because either way, Stacy can hook you up. Stacy has an entire rectum firm. Oh, come on, don't be like that. Hi, I would like a vanilla frappuccino with 3 pumps of caramel sauce and a soft dash mocha and 4 pumps of... Whoa, calm down there, Karen. Can I call you Karen? Your name is legally Karen. This is a murder hardware store. I don't got 4 pumps of anything for you, so how about you just get the hell out of my store? Why are you giving me so much money for standing up to you? Is this some kind of kink? Because I don't like it. Can you point me to the frozen food section? I think you might be a little confused, old man. Like, aisle 3 is full of freezers, but they're intended for bodies. Like, this is a hardware store. You could just go along your way. Yeah, it's just down the road. We got $100? That's it? I could go home and squeeze that out of my bunny in 5 minutes. Oh, you can't be serious. You're paying me in peanuts and you're making me work overtime? Look at this piss-covered floor. That's not piss. That's way worse than piss. All right, well, let's just work our way out so that we hopefully don't need to step on any of this. Oh, dear. The edges of existence don't handle well in this emulation of reality. Maybe we could just do a little something like that. There, we're close enough. Hey, that made me happy. Who would have guessed working in a place without diarrhea tiles makes you happy? You know what? I think that's going to be it for this episode of Karen Simulator. Guys, no, speak to the manager. And I gotta say, you know, after you spend a couple bucks in the game to clear out some ads, it's a whole lot better. So hopefully you guys appreciate that. You know, if you do enjoy it, you want to leave a like in the video, I would definitely appreciate that because I would like to play more. Things are actually going places now. We no longer live in a crack den. We've got ourselves a girlfriend. We're getting promotions and jobs. I want to see how far you can take this. But thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.